Hey, my hair is like driving me nuts, man. I am like 30 seconds. I'm buzzing it here. I need to have the back of my neck trimmed so bad. I just try to do around my ears, my sideburns, but what the fuck, man? Gotta get my big clippers out, I think. I think I'm just gonna have to do it. I can't get it to. I can't get it to do nothing. Just freaking driving me nuts. So anyway, yeah, it's just gonna look messed up for this video, I guess. I don't know what the hell's going on. Anyway, this is why I constantly wear a fucking ball cap. I gotta get my ball cap. See, once you apply the ball cap, you cannot tell that the butch has the bad haircut right now, and it's like not a bad haircut, it's just it needs to either be cut or keep the fucking ball cap on until it grows out or something. Because at this particular stage it just sucks, and not having somebody around all the time that knows what the hell they're doing with trimming it sucks too. So I get my mom to do it, but she just doesn't really know how to do it, except for just to shave it down. She doesn't like it shaved down all the way. And I actually think it makes me look older shaved down all the way, so I need to. And we don't need to make Mainelybutch look any fucking older than I am. I don't know what the hell to do with it, so I guess I gotta go over and see the girl that cuts it regularly and let her just fix it. But yeah, it's driving me nuts. I was pretty sore today, man, from all the shit I did yesterday. I couldn't believe it. But I'm just not used to because of my back injuries, doing all that lifting and carrying and holding and all this stuff. And I'm also trying to get ready for a show on Saturday, like I had said. And so I've been lugging all that equipment up out of the shed, getting it tuned up, lubed up. Lubed up and ready to go, so that I'm like ready to go set up. It's only a one day show, so I'm not hauling everything there. So my t-shirt press is gonna stay here. I'm gonna need no shirts for this show. I'm gonna do a bunch of pre-printed shirts for the next show. That t-shirt press weighs about, I think, like about 180 pounds, and it's solid steel, and it does mugs, t-shirts, plates, hats, all that type of shit. It's a hot press, and so it's really cool, and I can, make t-shirts of any design with the proper software, which I think I'm gonna buy some new software. I'm not sure. I've been kind of poking around, looking at different stuff, looking at maybe taking a subscription to clip art, which gives you access to millions of images that you can use free, copyright free, to make whatever you want. Plus I can buy transfers, all the different ones there, the copyrighted ones like Harley-Davidson and stuff. I can buy those. Pretty cheap, and make shirts at a pretty reasonable price. So anyway, yeah, I'm not gonna haul that to the show. So we're not gonna do, I'm just gonna do the buttons and the magnets and stuff because it's just a one day deal, town festival. But I got a 2 day one coming up next month that I think I'm gonna do, with any luck. And if that pans out, I'm not sure if I'll have shirts ready for that fair or not. So we'll see. I love this time of year for that. I love doing the fairs, the bigger fairs are more fun because you get to interact with a lot of the full-time carnies, which, carnies are just a fucking blast, man. Rennies and carnies are cool. And I've got a pretty good rapport with a bunch of them because, they travel. Some of them are LGBT, and they travel all around the country, and they come up here in the fall, and I get to see them again like every year, which is really cool. I wanted to do that at one time, go full time on the carny route, but I don't think my back would take it, you know? I mean, I did an 11-day gig at Topsfield Fair about 5 years ago, and it almost killed my ass. I took a 34-foot camper with me, and stayed in the camper for the 10 nights, I guess. And yeah, sleeping on that like 3-inch thick camper mattress, even though it's like a queen size mattress, or no, I guess I was up in the, yeah, that, I don't know if that was a queen or a double, I can't remember, but because I didn't go in the back, I stayed up in the front most of the time. So no, yeah, because I had a kid, a runaway with me that I had employed for the show. I mean, you know, you meet carnies, you meet runaways, you know. And I employed him for the show, and I let him stay in my camper as part of his payment for working my booth. We made a lot of money them 11 days, so that was actually a pretty good fare. And we didn't have a great location. We were directly crossing the pig races. I have been directly crossing the pig races twice, and that's actually pretty cool because I get to watch the little piggies run around in little circles chasing their Oreos. That's how they get the pigs to run in the pig races, people. They use Oreo cookies, you know. The pink pigs chase the rainbow cookies really good. Yeah. I'm funny, huh? Anyway, joking. They're regular fucking Oreos, but that's what they chase. That's what those pigs want when they run in that circle. They're after that Oreo. They know when they get to the other end of that circle that that Oreo is waiting for their ass. So, and I actually did a whole bunch of buttons of pigs for the actual the outfit that was running the pigs. They bought a shitload of them off me one that year at Topsfield and resold them. Oh, you know, 'cause I cut the price on them for them, because I did so many bulk when I was not working, you know, individuals, and they sold a lot of those pig buttons to people, so, of their favorite pigs. I put the name of the pig on there, and the number, and the little pig's face, and people just fucking sucked them right up. They loved them. Anyway, so yeah, I'm a little sore today, but I'm making it, I'm making it. Gotta build some muscle back up, you know, start doing something a little different. It just shows me a little bit of how out of shape I have become. So yeah, you don't notice it, you know, when you're I don't know, I guess, you know, I lost a lot of weight. Maybe that some of that was muscle weight, you know, I don't fucking know. But you know, I've stayed steady now where I am, and I think it's time to start doing a little daily workout thing to try to get a little stronger, you know, if I can do it without killing my back. So yeah, so it's only one thing that don't hurt my back. Makes me totally forget about my back. I'll let you think about that. Have a good day.